Point 1. Once upon a time, the wealthiest were those with most natural resources. Like Saudi Arabia, which is the biggest exporter of oil in the world. As it has the biggest reserves of oil. But today's world is knowledge economy. Where the more you know is proportional to more data that you have. Point 2. Energy can be extracted from oil using refineries and modern-day plants. Same way, information can be extracted from data. Using modern-day processing framework. Like Apache Spark, Big Data Framework. Point 3. Traditional oil powered the transportation era, in the same way. Data is also powering the emerging transportation options. Like driverless cars and Hyperloop, 1,200 km per hour. Which are based on advanced synthesis of data. Point 4. Traditional oil is finite. As per one study in 2014-15, there are 1.688 trillion barrels oil left. Which would be good to go for next 53 years. Data availability seems infinite. There are 2.5 quintillion bytes of data created each day at our current pace. But that pace is only accelerating. With the growth of the Internet of Things, IoT, over the last 2 years alone, 90% of the data in the world was generated. Point 5. Data flows like oil, but we must drill down into data to extract value from it. Data promises a plethora of new uses. Diagnosis of diseases, direction of traffic patterns, etc. Just as oil has produced useful plastics, petrochemicals, lubricants, gasoline, and home heating. Point 6. Oil is a scarce resource. There is a limited quantity of this natural resource. Like any other natural resource, it is bound to vanish on some day. Data isn't just abundant, it is a cumulative resource. Means, it's going to continuously increase and will keep increasing more in future. Point 7. If oil is being used, then the same oil cannot be used somewhere else. Because it's a rival good. Means, consumption destroys the good, allowing only one user to enjoy it. This results in a natural tension about who controls oil. If data is being used, the same data can be used elsewhere. Because it's a non-rival good. Point 8. As a tangible product, oil faces high friction, transportation and storage costs. As an intangible product, data has much lower friction, transportation and storage costs. Point 9. The life cycle of oil is defined by process. Extraction, refining, distribution. The life cycle of data is defined by relationships with other data, with context and with itself via feedback loops.